Igneous rocks are formed as melted rock cools and crystallizes. A characteristic of igneous rocks is that their crystals are tightly locked together. Melted rock that cools quickly produces small crystals. Slow cooling produces larger crystals. This is the fourth and last video in our series on volcanoes. In this video, you will learn about volcanic plumes, types of igneous rocks and how to identify them based on the size of the crystals and which igneous rocks have been used to create giant rock sculptures, like the four presidents carved into stone on Mount Rushmore. The pyroclastic flow from a composite volcano eruption may form a thick layer of hot cinders and ash called welded tuft. Other layers mark the pulses of a pyroclastic flow. Pumice is collected from these layers for use in commercial cleaning products as an abrasive. When a volcano erupts, it throws ash and volcanic lava high into the atmosphere, creating a plume. In 1991, Mount Pinatubo erupted and created a plume that rose 40 kilometers into the stratosphere. The Mount St. Helens eruption of 1980 created a plume that carried ash halfway across the United States. Pumice as a material is very light. Although it has jagged edges, the interior of a pumice or volcanic ash particle is riddled with holes. The picture on the bottom right shows children trying to scrape volcanic ash off of cars. When rain is added to volcanic ash, it becomes very thick and cement-like. Basalt and gabbro are made from the same silica pore basalt magma. Basalt has fine crystals, but gabbro has large crystals. Basalt is a surface-formed rock, and gabbro is formed below the Earth's surface. Granite cools underground and has large crystals. Granite makes up the continental plates. Mount Rushmore is a famous granite-sculptured mountain. Carved by Gutzon Borglum, Mount Rushmore is in South Dakota. It was finished after 14 years of work in 1941. This granite mountain depicts the faces of George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Teddy Roosevelt, and Abraham Lincoln, all famous American presidents. The Crazy Horse Memorial in the Black Hills of South Dakota commemorates Crazy Horse, a respected member of the Oglala Lakota, a Native American Indian noted for his courage in battle. The Crazy Horse sculpture, like the Mount Rushmore sculpture, is carved from a granite mountain. Granite, rhyolite, and obsidian all come from the same silica-rich magma. Granite cools underground and has large crystals. Rhyolite cools on the surface and has fine crystals. Obsidian cools so fast that it has no crystals. Obsidian is often called volcanic glass. Try your hand at decoding the secret message. There are 8 words. Read the message from the top of the column down on the left, and again on the right to decipher the message. This is a symbol font called American Natives.